What hobbies are cheap slash easy to get started in? Gardening. Not that easy, but you can always grow small plants at first. True, I got a basil seed packet for Christmas. I might just start with that. Old Chinese proverb, the best time to plant a tree was 20 years ago. The second best time is now. D&D, all you need is friends crying. Exercising. This is the best answer. Costs nothing to go outside, and has the best benefits of any hobby you could get into. Outside is ideal, but many people live in nasty climates, like me. I'm lucky enough to have gym access where I work, and there are tons of aerobic machines. ; Trainspotting. All you need is a railway station and some heroin. And heroin is cheap as hell. Fentanyl is cheaper. Plus you won't have to spend as much time looking for new hobbies because you'll die. Hiking. Reading. Try not to do them at the same time. Read after you've set up for the night. 5/5. r/brocker hobbies. Anything but Magic the Gathering. Except MTG Arena now exists. I've spent $0. I've already bought 25 packs from the new set with in-game currency, which I earned. But you don't get to play with slivers, so yeah. Cross-stitch. I got a hoop and 3 kits from Jones for $15. Each pattern can take a while to complete depending on size slash how much time you dedicate. Plus it's relaxing. Meditation. It's really strange that a lot of people don't realize you can basically trip balls if you meditate. LE5. How can I get started to meditate properly? Headspace and also Waking Up are two popular meditation apps. I recommend using headphones, preferably noise cancelling, to get started, since it's difficult to block out external noises for the first week or so. Once you get into the habit, try to do it every day, it'll start to feel more natural, and you'll notice the benefits. Don't be discouraged if you don't feel any major effects after the first few sessions. It can take a week or more to start to feel that zen state. Remember to keep your breathing pattern slow and steady, and try to meditate when you know you will have at least 15 minutes afterward to decompress. Hope that helps. Check out the Meditation Essentials course. It's very thorough and based off of tried and true ancient teachings. Find people trying their best on Reddit and give them a nice comment. Edit. Curse you, kind stranger. That's an excellent recommendation. Nice job. D. This is the most wholesome exchange I've seen all day. Exchanging postcards. Don't know how much postage costs in your country, but it is relatively cheap where I'm from. I've gotten some pretty cool stuff from the mail, like tea, stickers, candies, and even a mini painting. Plus, it's always nice to learn about people, cultures, or even just random stuff. Plus and I have something to look forward to each day. Postcrossing is wonderful. Radio. The physics of it are actually pretty simple. And for like $20 you can get a radio that connects to your computer. You can hear everything in your area. Police, local radio stations, walkie-talkies. There are even amateur radio bands that you can listen to regular people looking for someone to talk to. Alternatively, you can receive signals from satellites and decode them into images of Earth, which I think is crazy cool. Pirate radio. Have you tried masturbating? It's free and it's pretty okay, I guess. Do you know if there are any good communities or clubs for that? It's kind of hard to find fellow masturbation enthusiasts in my town. We tried a meetup once, but couldn't get past the handshakes. Programming. Visual Studio Community Edition is free for individuals and supports a vast array of different languages, from the relatively easy VB.NET to the more complex stuff like C/C++. Even supports programming Android/iPhone apps in C#. Disc Golf. Came to say this. Time per dollar spent, it doesn't get much better than disc. I too came here to say this. Didn't read many other posts, just scanned to make sure disc golf was included. Also, there's an amazing and welcoming community behind disc golf. Just about everyone I know involved is interested in growing the sport and teaching others. Anything regarding fitness. Most gym memberships are fairly cheap, and even cheaper. Hiking, outdoor running, etc. Is podcasting a hobby? Drawing. I'm pissed at myself for getting into drawing, because now I spend hundreds of dollars on art supplies. It started out as a cheap hobby, but over time it becomes anything but. Get a library card, and take advantage of all their resources. Not only can you borrow books, but a lot of them have great movie and video game collections. You can also use your library account to access Lynda.com and all of their learning videos on there. Also, be sure to check out the events and clubs hosted by your library. You might be surprised at a lot of the cool things you can do for free/cheap. Knitting and crochet. Buy a set of needles and or a crochet needle, some yarn and get to it. The needles are a permanent utensil and all you have to do is buy yarn at times. Watch videos on how start to knit/crochet. It's not that difficult, really. And the outcome is both useful and beautiful. But yarn can get expensive. It can, but I feel like the hours I spend using yarn make it relatively cheap for how much time a project occupies. I can make a small baby blanket for about $12 and just working on it, when I have time, it takes at least a month. I also like it, because I can watch TV and still feel like I'm doing something productive. As strange as it sounds, game development can be a cheap hobby, especially for 2D. God, it is a free, in both beer and speech, and easy to use once you start learning. For art, use Critter or Acuprite. Critter is pretty normal drawing program, while Acuprite is used for pixel art. Both are technically free. Acuprite is $15, but could be compiled for free. If you don't want to get create your own art, websites like itch.io have free assets you can use. Learning a language. You can learn just about any language for free with online resources and free books from the library. Board games. Go to meetup.com and search your area for board games. Most likely there are one or more groups that meet regularly nearby. Contact the group admin and request an invite. You're in. No one cares if you own any games or not. Nearly all groups are happy to have more players. Rubik's Cube Solving. But don't buy the Rubik's brand. You can get a $10 Chinese speed cube that works 100 times better than a Rubik's brand. Playing Nintendo games on emulators. If you have some old laptop, you can probably play emulated games very easily. Add in a $15 controller from Amazon or something, and you're pretty much set. I noticed I can't get enjoyment out of those games nearly how I used to. I have Northeast's SNES, N64. I'll start a game and stop playing 5 minutes later. Anybody else get this? I feel that as my responsibilities increased, every time I picked up the controller, the thought of every other productive thing I could be doing ran through my mind and made me want to set the game down. As of late though, I have another theory brewing. Despite my above concern, I find myself on my phone more than ever. Perhaps my brain has become accustomed to the more frequent hits that using my phone provides, rather than whatever happens from playing games. The market for your attention is truly being sharpened to a science. Trash tag. You get thousands of karma for it too. Geocaching. It only costs whatever a GPS is, if you don't already have one, and gas money. Plus it gets you exercise, and you can see some neat shit. Amazing what I never knew existed within 50 miles of my house. You don't even need a GPS to get you started. Your phone should work nicely. Not so much in more rural areas though. I looked into this but was underwhelmed by needing to pay for location clues. The geocache clues were behind a paywall. I was younger and $10 was a lot back then, so is that standard? Or is there a better way to go about it? Pay? No, no. You must be using the wrong software then, I guess. Go to geocaching.com, register for free, download the geocaching app, and you're set. Free hints and everything. Guitar isn't actually that expensive to start up with. You can get a crappier guitar to start on, and there's lots of good content on YouTube if you look in the right places. If you get really into it, you can upgrade guitars, but even a starter guitar can sound really good. Stalking your crush. You can buy old Vans on Craigslist for cheap, and Goodwill is bound to have trench coats. Fishing. Walking. A lot of hobbies can be done for free. But if you're looking for something to pay for that is cheap, a gym membership is a good investment, and working out can turn into a hobby. Personally, exercise is my hobby. Art class or drawing is a good idea. Visiting museums or art galleries perhaps. Depends what you feel like you might enjoy. It's all personal preference, so it's a bit of trial and error, and finding out for yourself. Baking, trying to cook new recipes, or getting into horticulture to add to the list. If you're new here, hey, how are you doing? If you're subscribed, hey, how are you doing? It's very good to see you. If you are new, and you too want an extra greeting at the end of each episode, subscribe. Anyway, see you next time.